Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. And if you've been following along on our rebuild series on this 2004 Yamaha F225, well, it's finally time to reinstall our rebuilt lower unit to our rebuilt power head and midsection. So, are there any special tools? No, just regular hand tools. That's all they're going to be required. Parts, not going to need any for this particular exercise. So, let me get this thing tilted up and we'll show you how to get it reinstalled. We've got her tilted up and I'm getting ready to release it from its stand and then get it reinstalled. But before I do so, I want to go ahead and take some red Loctite and put it on our bolts, because you really don't want these to work their way out. And once you get this thing up in position, you need to have the Loctite on there because, well, you're going to run out of hands. So let me get a little bit of Loctite on each one of these threads. We'll release the lower unit, then get it installed. Let's add a little bit of grease on the shift shaft. And our water pickup, our pass-through. One more thing that we need to check is to make sure that we're in neutral, and we are. Now would be a good time to check the shifting mechanism up on the outboard itself to make sure it's in that neutral position as well. Yep, she's dead center. Last, let's coat down the splines on our input shaft. We're going to guide this up. Then the real tricky part is making sure that the shift shaft lines up as well as your water tube. There we go. There's the water. There's the shift shaft. Okay, that's the first one of six that go around the front and the sides. And we're going to get the other five in. Then we'll have one that's hidden up in here. And then there's another bolt that goes back down that actually holds the trim tab in place. And then hidden right back here is where number seven goes. And each one's going to go to 34 foot-pounds. Is not a lot of torque. That's why that red Loctite is so important. Let's get that longer one in place. Foot-pounds on that longer one as well. Now let's get our trim tab in place. I'm just going to set it at a zero for right now, because we'll have to fine-tune it when we actually install this on a boat. This is a little bit less torque, 31 foot-pounds. Well, all right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. What's going to happen next? Well, I'm going to go ahead and put all the panels and covers back on it. Then we're going to roll it outside and actually start it up for the first time. So if you'd like to see that happen, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you'll be notified when we release that particular video. And hey, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at Boats.net and we can get you taken care of. Once again, we just want to say thanks for watching and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.